themselves Bobby. And once again, Dave is going to annoy us with his insane yet occasionally relevant questions. Today, for your enjoyment, we have Circus Rhapsody from Berlin, Germany. Welcome.
Hello. Okay. Thanks for having me.
Welcome in, God a Printer presents. Wir mochten Sie als unseren Gaste begrüßen zu dürfen. Hast du eine Schwester? Ist sie wunderschön? Und would sie mich gern treffen? Okay, kein Witze mehr, lass uns anfangen. Ich hab das nicht so sehr vermasselt.
Ach so, du sprichst Deutsch. Dann brauche ich ja gar kein Englisch zu reden. Das freut mich.
Yeah,
yeah. I talk German. I don't have to. And I learned all the English over the week. For nothing. So we talk German. It's cool.
Heck no.
Hallo, wie geht es dir?
That's all I got. That's all I got.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Pretty good.
Jay, wait. Did you understand it at least?
After the second or third sentence, I know that you wanted to talk German. Yeah, but
Yeah. Well, when I was trying to practice it, I was like, shit, for the next time around, I'm going to learn how to speak German.
And yes, I have a sister. I can't say if she's that beautiful, but married at least. So I guess she find her love.
Awesome. Okay, what about the ich hoff? Ich hab das nicht so sehr vermasselt. Did that make sense? I thought the trends, yeah. I meant to say, I hope I didn't fuck this up too bad.
One more time in German.
Ich hoff, ich hab das nicht so sehr vermasselt.
Ah, vermasselt. Ich hoffe, ich habe das nicht so sehr vermasselt. Ah, pretty good. I like. Yeah, it's good. Great.
All right. Okay, cool. Very cool. So we're off to a fantastic start. Awesome. Okay, right. Now I just meant to say, bitstellen Sie sich vor.
Okay, sehr gerne. You want me to do it in English or in German?
English. Okay. No more German.
Okay. It's a nice. I mean, it's a nice language. Maybe a bit aggressive.
Oh, I know. I like it. Like
a little bit. Hello. I'm Michael. I am the bass player and singer of Circus Rhapsody. We are a Berlin-based punk band who also do like folk punk, a bit of ska, a bit of rockabilly. We are around for 12 years now.
Wow.
Maybe you see it on my face. I was very young when we started. We are about to release our third album. And we wait for now over a year to release it because of obvious reasons. When we will back on tour, we will release the album. And I'm looking very forward to it. Until then, nothing, I guess.
So how many people are in your band? How many members?
Yeah, we are four on stage.
There's four.
I mean, I could introduce them. Like, we have Catherine on the violin, our drummer Eric. In English, I would say Mahes. His name is Mahatze on the guitar. Me, Michael, and our long time friend Lucas, who is our roadie, and Ala, who do the cotton candy machine on stage.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. So we are six in the band. Four musicians.
Nice. So first off, I need to get this out of the way. Is David Hasselhoff really as big of a star in Germany?
When I was a little kid, I had kids I don't know the word in English. You know, my blanket, the thing you cover the blanket with. So.
Yeah.
Like a duvet?
Yeah. And I had kit on it.
Yes, nice. Yes, Knight Rider.
So, for me, David Hasselhoff is a thing.
Yeah.
But when I get it right in history class, he wasn't the reason the Berlin Wall fell. I guess. I'm not sure, but I guess. Yeah. We know him. We know him well. Yeah. He had some hits on the radio. We don't see him in TV.
Okay.
We have our own little ass on Germany Search the Superstar.
Okay.
He did it in America, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. We have Dieter Bohlen of Modern Talking for it. Maybe you know them. Never mind. but I love me and Catherine, our violin player, we always, on every party and on every drive we do with the band, we always hear the one song. Action, if we're gonna take it like a true survivor. Another one? Oh, there's this super trashy student action movie, you know that? Yeah, oh, I love it. What was it? Nazi dinosaurs, Vikings, robots, future, boom, action. Oh, wow, 20 minutes, everything. Oh.
Okay, you have a very unique sound. You combine a number of styles and it results in an incredible sound. Was this always your plan or was it the result of too many beers in the pub?
Yeah, thank you. I guess it's more a curse than a gift to want to be a punk band but know how to play your instrument. Yeah, okay. I guess that's one part of the answer. I started, I'm a big Misfits fan. When I was 14, 15, I had my first group and we all did Misfits covers. We loved that Devil Lock style and all that kind of stuff. And I have a big brother who's 10 years older than me. So from him, I got all the punk music from America. And I loved it when I was young.
And I loved your the acoustic set that you did of the Misfits. Oh. That was really good.
Oh, yeah,
really
right.
Cool. Yeah, really cool.
What I say, I had this Misfits cover band for like 2 or 3 years before we start to write our own songs. There is this bar, this pub here in Berlin. It's called Franken. It's right over the street of the SO36, which is like, I would say, like our German CBGBs.
Oh, like okay.
The big punk club where all the big acts have. So like in the 90s when Bad Religion and NoFX and all those right. came over to Germany, they all played in the Ethos 36. And the pub who were the same owner, not anymore, but it's right over the street. And I'm friends with the owner of the pub. And every once in a while I do theme evenings. Like that was the Misfits evening. And stuff, or we do Ramones evenings or something like that. Yeah, it's and that was a thing for the heart for me, like my favorite pub, my favorite music, played myself, drink for free.
Like, that's the most important kind of stuff.
Yeah.
And your first blood.
This one's called First Blood. My brother told me years ago, hey man, I just watched all the Rambo movies in a row and you have to do a song named First Blood. Okay, dear brother, this one's for you. It's from our second album called Telling Horror Stories. Oh, 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 this is the first blood, first blood. This is the first part of my revenge.
Absolutely love what you've done with it. Just the combination of all the different styles. It's such a cool sound. It's such a cool sound. I mean, one of my favorite songs, and it's Chucky.
Yeah, me too.
And I just love the whole, like, you've got this whole, it's like a vaudevillian sideshow, like the circus theme, right? With your video and stuff. At times I don't know whether to laugh or be really scared. You know, it's like, yeah.
You know the Happy Tree Friends? The Happy Tree Friends was like, I know, one of the first internet things I knew when I was like 15, 16. It's like, you see the buddies on my sides, the boy and the girl who are on every cover of every album and every merch we do. It's that style. You see little sweet bunny who got hacked by an axe. Like, oh, sweet. Oh. That's creepy. And I loved that at the time. And I love Queen. That's why the Rhapsody is in the name.
Is the punk scene big in Germany?
In Flensburg, where I come from, it was a thing. The only club there has an owner who was totally into hardcore and punk. And so there was a scene just because it were the only chance to see a concert.
You had no choice.
It was like, okay, that's the music you hear when you grow older and start to drink beer and stuff. Berlin is the same, I guess. It was the same when I come here when I was 20. It was like, okay, the scene here is much bigger. You don't know every person. The bigger bands come here to Berlin because it's the capital of Germany. But over the years, big techno electro acts grow here and the scene grow, and so the punk scene gets smaller over the years in Berlin.
What about the other cities like Hamburg is it a close-knit community?
If the punk scene is close, you mean inside the cities or the country?
You know, in not just Germany, but I mean, have you toured much out like throughout Europe and stuff like that?
The smaller the town, the bigger the scene. And that's why we love to play in the small towns. Sure, you have to play Hamburg, Cologne, Munich, Berlin, kind of that. The only four big cities in the country. You do that because when people ask you, oh, you were on tour, where were you? You couldn't say Buxtehude. You would say it was Munich. Oh, sounds like that. Yeah. So you do the cities, but you love to play the small towns.
Love playing the small towns. Yeah.
In England or Great Britain is it's more like they have a bunch of punk and hardcore labels who are like they run all the labels all together, like they have a community, and it's hard to meet them the first time, sure, because we're from another country and we talk a different language. But if you're inside the community, you have the same background. Yeah.
So you need to go the secret handshake.
You get to know them first. Yeah. It's not that easy to get this footstep over the border.
Right.
That's the hard part. But if you do that once, you can do it like every year. We played, I don't know, the first 6 years we only played in Germany, which is not that big as a country if you see the States or something like that. But once we were in Britain, it was like an easiest thing to get more connected to the scene, to the people, to the promoters and stuff like that. Yeah. And 3 years ago, 2018, we did a two seven inch and found a little London based label. And so that was the point that we say, okay, we are inside the country. Now we can play everywhere because the people know us, there's promotion for us and stuff like that. Yeah. We toured with a Canadian band called The Ones. I don't know if you know them. It's like more folk, very melodic. A few years ago, and they, I don't know how big they are in Canada. They are big, kind of big. They are friends of Passenger. Maybe you know them, the British guy. Oh, you know, you've been high when you're feeling low. Only need the sun when it starts to snow. No, never mind. they did a featuring of on a song of the last album, Zombies Ate My Neighbors. And so what you always say when you say goodbye, when you ever come to Canada, let's get in touch and stuff like that. There is a little festival in Pennsylvania who like to book us for this summer.
Okay. And
that would be the great thing, the great routing to do Canada, so we could do all the big cities in Canada.
Sorry, you guys could definitely start by crashing at our place, and then we can't guarantee that you'll make any money, but we'll have lots of shows.
And we'll have lots of beer.
And lots of beer.
Oh, right. You got me. Yeah. Ich bin dabei. Go. Dankeschön. Yeah, I'm not optimistic for this summer that this COVID thing will end. I do the booking very slow at the moment. Like, I say hello to the promoters, but I really don't know if anything will happen.
You just want to make sure they remember who you are. It's like, hey, this is me.
Yeah, right. We talked 2 years ago when this thing called concert was a thing. Let's do that again. It was fun.
Back to the pandemic thing. How has it affected your guys? Like, you guys haven't obviously done much since the pandemic. Are you guys doing any online stuff? Or
did a little session called the quarantine session, Sing My Song, My Dear Friends. It was like we met so many bands over the years we loved. And that's why we have nothing to do. So let's cover each other. That's why we did this thing. So we do a song of you do a song of us. So there will be content. Our friends will have something to our fans. So we'll have new music for them.
Very cool.
It was a nice project. It is a nice project. Still is on. Yeah.
Just to maintain some social interaction. Keep in touch. Yeah.
And that's it. Yeah. What I always say is like, you're a musician, so you have many friends you see once a year. So they are best friends, and you meet them every year once. And if you don't do that, you get lost. Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's why it was cool and nice to just the first three bands I asked before we did that. So could you expect to do that with us? It would be a cool idea. And now we just, okay, here's the song, your turn. And that's nice because they did it with their friended bands. And so the whole quarantine session was kind of thing. Yeah.
Like, who are your musical influences? Who did you listen to growing up and stuff?
I loved Die Benetzten Schrötzer.
Oh, very yes, of
course. Cool punk band from Pittsburgh.
You're the best.
Wow, I love that one song. Like,
I was going to ask if there were other bands, local bands for you guys that we should be looking at. Like, if cool. there's anybody that you think needs what is a shout out?
Yeah, shout out. You say those, yeah. I guess. The best answer for that would be watch the quarantine session and take every band out of it, because they're all great. The bands who are the closest to us lately is the band Dino Sound. It's like a band from here, from Berlin. I have to say the guitar player is my brother-in-law. And the singer recorded our last album. So we are, and we play together a few times. The drummer plays gigs with us sometimes if our drummer's out for some reasons. So they are like family.
Yeah.
They actually are family. Yeah, right. <Yes.
laughs> Is it true that the government actually pays for the disabled to have sex with prostitutes? And do the disabled get to pick who they want to have sex with? Like, that's pretty cool, if it's true.
I have to say I'm not 100% sure, because it's not my I work in a kindergarten, so I don't work with disabled people, handicapped people. I really don't know, but I heard about that too, that there is a chance if you're really not able to move yourself, you can Oh, that is a question. my answer is I guess it is a real thing, yeah. Right. Yeah. I guess. But don't let me pay if I'm wrong, please.
If you can meet or play with any musician, living or dead, who would it be and why?
Oh, there are a couple. There are many musicians I love to play with. Like I would love to sing a duet with Freddie Mercury. It was like the big thing in my life, if that could happen. And also, Brian May would be the first, the best choice for a guitar battle with our guitarist, because I know he loves him. That's a nice hard question. I love Nicola of Millencolin. I would love to sing with him, or Cody of Teenage Bottle Rocket, maybe Zoli of Ignite. He has a great voice, and I'm sure I forgot many.
I have a 7-year-old daughter, and we always ask questions from her. So she gave you a few questions.
Do you like kids?
Children love music, and that was always like my thing. If the group is too big, if the kids are too loud or anything, it's like, okay, I have the guitar and now I got you. And these kind of happiness you see when people are into something, kids are into something, is what I really love about the job.
Yeah.
Like, they are not polite. Like, okay, I like that, but I be quiet. But like, oh, I love it. Michael C, I got something. So I love that.
Do you have any pets?
No, but me and my wife, we have an imaginary cat. It's called Ive. And it's a beautiful little thing. We had for years, and we never have a problem if we want to go to holidays or
And I assume the food budget is pretty low.
It is. It really is. Yeah.
Yeah. And the litter box. Never have to clean the litter box. What?
Yeah. Sometimes you don't see her for days. Yeah. But I don't know. She's at the moment.
Have you ever been bullied?
I've been bullied a lot when I was a child. I'm a hat wearer my whole life, and when I was young, they loved to steal it.
Oh!
And I hated it. But yeah.
What would you tell the kids to how to react to bullies?
When I was young, I was too shy to talk about it. The German word for bullying is mobbing. But when I was young, the word wasn't a thing. There was no name for it. It was like, people are mean to you, but there it was no thing. Like, this is bullying. And I'm glad that it has a name now. And I guess the most important thing is to talk about it.
Right.
To tell not only people or your parents or your teachers, but also the people who bully you. Make it clear. You know what you do at the moment. You bully me, and you make me sad, and it destroys me. And I guess it's important to say that. Maybe it changes something, and if not, it's good for your soul.
How long have you been in Berlin for?
I moved here when I was 20 for 13, nearly 13 years now.
What's your most memorable birthday present you've ever gotten?
When I was 6 years, I got my Super Nintendo.
Oh, yeah.
It was a game changer for me. I mean, I could name any other thing, but when you're young, you are very into your presents when it's your birthday. So I guess it's that Nintendo. I still have it. And with YouTube videos, I learned how to fix it when something broke. So I love that little machine.
I want to, create the dialogue, right? So, and show that, because I think, when I was playing in my parents' basement, it was all of these bands. They were rock stars, and I was like, wow, I could never do that, like.
Our local heroes were, in our eyes, as big as national acts or international acts. It's like, okay, they play the one club we have, and it's full of people, so they have to be rock stars, aren't they? And years later, you see, okay, that's not true. But yeah, then I don't understand why you should act like a rock star.
Yeah,
because you're not big. No, nobody is. Like, okay, exactly. I don't know, you're not Paul McCartney or something. Right? Yeah. And even Paul McCartney, I guess it's more polite than you, asshole, at the moment, to just play in front of 200 people and think you are a big shit. I don't know.
We got to go to typical questions.
Yeah.
How are you? Hello.
What's the weather like over there?
What's your favorite color?
Yes. Hey, that could be another question.
Yeah.
Actually, I have a good answer for that.
Okay.
My answer is my favorite color is green, because we have an internet calendar for the gigs, and if we have a gig who is confirmed, it's colored green, so we all know this gig will happen, and that's why I love it.
Have you ever had an embarrassing moment on stage?
I am embarrassing on stage. That's my kind of show. That's what I do.
Do you got any questions for us right now?
Metallica or Iron Maiden?
Metallica.
Right.
I have issues with Metallica.
I went to their concert. They were awesome.
My very first concert when I was in grade 6 was Twisted Sister and Iron Maiden, Power Slave tour.
Yeah, Power Slave. That's good.
No, I love Iron Maiden.
My first concert was New Kids on the Block.
that is something. which song was New Kids on the Block?
Hanging tough.
Yes.
Have you ever been to North America?
I hope we can. I plan to come with the bands. But we'll see when it's possible.
I think you guys should start in Edmonton. And then we'll line up gigs all through Alberta. Then we'll go to the West Coast. We'll go to British Columbia. We'll do Vancouver. We'll do Victoria. Then we'll go down into Seattle. Then we'll go down to LA. I got it all set up.
All right.
I got it all figured out. Motorhead, what's your take on Lemmy?
That's a funny thing. My brother and me, we are very close, I have to say that. Every year, we drive to our parents over Christmas.
Yeah.
And on the way, we always use the slow train, which is much, much cheaper. And so we could drink Jackie Coke over 9 hours while we drive.
Yeah.
Because we celebrate the birthday of Lemmy. And that's why I have to say, and we always, when we cheers, or we prost in German, we always do it like one to heaven and one the other way around, because you never know.
Yeah.
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 Lemmy is still in our hearts.
His passing was...
But yeah, I always got told from everybody who met him that he's very polite and very, very nice, nice guy. Never was like, I'm the big shit, leave me alone. But say, okay, you know what? I'm with friends now. I don't want this fan thing now. So if you could just leave us. So, but always in this kind of talking out.
Yeah.
And that's fair. And I think if Lemmy could do that, everybody could be at least that polite and that nice to people.
Well put.
What's your favorite song to perform that of your own?
Two answers. The newest, for once. And the other thing is we got a song called Winchester. It's on the album. Yeah, it's like my father is very into Irish folk music. Sure he is. And we had this one night, and I thought I had this melody, this la 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 la, which is the violin melody. You know, I was like, Father, I don't have an idea what. I guess it will be a folk song or folk punk song or something like that, but I don't have an idea for the lyrics and for the rest of the melody. And so he always played guitar for his whole life, but he never wrote songs. And this one night we sat together, drank whiskey, and wrote this song together.
Nice.
And since then I know, it's very emotional. So it's a good story. Beautiful. It's always a favorite of the audience. So it's always our last song in the set. So everyone can sing this. La 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 la. And that's why it's always the final song. And yeah.
Wow.
And I like Chucky as well. Because I wrote that song because I love skate punk and I always wanted to do that. I know we're not a skate punk band at all, but sometimes I win and can say, drummer, you do the double time beats, 220 beats per minute, and the guitar player play the easiest thing you can imagine. Okay. I love that.
You know, I was listening to everything that you had, and all of a sudden this one popped out, and I was like, fuck, that's cool. Yeah, that's like, I liked all of it. Like I said, I think you guys are incredible. I think we're like totally honored to have you on the show.
Yes, thank you so much.
And I hope that we can do sort of a follow up with the entire band at some.
When the pandemic's over.
Yeah, at some point. It's,
and we definitely have to talk about if you like the Telling Horror Stories album. This is nothing. The new one is so much more. And then we have to talk again. Yeah. Listen to that one and you will say, okay, wow, I had no idea this band can play. I really, oh, that is something I can talk about. When we were in the studio, it was like, okay, we have so many ideas for everything. Like we had this one song, there is a breakdown in it. And it was like, I forgot the rhythm. It was like, and now we need something heavy, like but the guitar and all the gain on the guitar wasn't heavy enough. So we took I don't know the English word. I have to look it up very quick. We used
distortion?
No, better. We used a drill. Sure, we used a drill. it's like so cool when you hear that you don't get what kind of sound is that. Is that the guitar with much distortion? No, it was like din 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 wheel, din 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 wheel, and that's the sound. And
nice.
There are a couple of things on the album. Like, okay, we want to use it all. We want to, yeah. That was very cool.
Shit, yeah.
I'm excited for your new album. So you definitely have to give us a when it's gonna come out.
Yeah,
we will see like how we do it on stage. But it will be awesome. And we also recorded our Cotton Candy Machine on one track because we have it for 10 years or something. It was like, okay, it never had his thing on the album, so now it's time. It's like a very cheap motor. It goes round and round.
Awesome.
That's the sound you want to get. That's very heavy. Yeah. yeah Just Kidding is the name of the album, and hopefully I can't wait to have a vinyl in my hand and can finally say, now I got it.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you.
This is. I hope you had somewhat of a good time.
I guess I had. I had. I had worse Sunday evenings. I mean, I have to say, I really don't know where the cat is. No, I had that much fun. Thank you for having me. It was very nice talking to you. Yeah.
Very cool. Very cool. Again, thank you so much for doing this. It's. I said that's. Really, really cool that you know, we put it together. No, I mean it.
It was my pleasure. It
and you know what?
Add that to the album.
Yeah, and then I'll fly to Germany and I'll operate the drill on stage.
All right, all right. Yeah. That's a deal.
I got my own power tools and everything.
Okay. Yeah. You have your instrument? I have. My bag full of tools.
I'm just here to drill.
Yeah, all right. Okay, at that time I will play Nintendo on stage.
Yes, and I'll take the drill and I'll drill the Nintendo, and then you'll fix it by watching YouTube.
He's like, oh, chaos. Touch my Nintendo.
Every fun has its end.